So let me see where I'm coming from. Let me tell you why I'm telling you all this. Sometime, whenever I preach, I don't want y'all to misunderstand me. Like, I'll talk about drinking. And some of you will hear me talk about drinking, and you may interpret whenever I'm talking about that, that I hate people that drinks. I don't hate people that drinks at all. You'll hear me talking about low-cut dresses, like I did last week, or tight clothes. And I have never been a clothesline preacher. My wife will tell you, I've never been a clothesline preacher. But you might say, Brother Kilpatrick, why are you talking about those things now? Here's one of the reasons. One of the reasons. Not the only reason, but one of the reasons. Because I love the presence of God so much. And I love the glory of God so much. I don't want nothing to cause that dove to fly. I don't want nothing to cause that dove to fly. Now listen. I don't want the Holy Spirit to be grieved. I certainly don't want to grieve Him. I don't want to make anybody here feel inferior. I don't want to make anybody here feel like I don't like you, or I don't trust you, or I think bad thoughts about you. No, I don't think any of those things. But here's where I'm coming from. What happened to Eli and what happened to Shiloh is they became too familiar with the holy, and they begin to profane the holy. And when you don't honor the holy and protect the holy, you see, my job is not to wear the title of Pastor John Kilpatrick or whatever you want to call me. Titles don't mean one hill of beans to me. I mean not one hill of beans. You can call me Reverend, that's fine. You can call me whatever you want to call me. It don't bother me at all. Call me John. That don't bother me. But my job is to be the protector of the glory of God. That's my job. That's my job. And have I seen in Brown? Have I seen in the Church of His Presence? Have I seen people acting hedonistic and dressing hedonistic? No, no. I even said last week, if you remember, whenever I was talking about this, and the devil fought me last week like you can't believe. I wasn't able to make myself clear because Leviathan was fighting me while I was preaching on Leviathan. His tail was knocking things over up here and all kind of stuff. Glory to God. Amen. I was having a rough time. But hear me now just for a minute. When I talk about women with low-cut dresses and tight clothes and all that, and men with tight jeans and women with tight clothes on that you see every print in their body, that doesn't mean that I'm an old-time Pentecostal holy roller preacher that preaches on clothes all the time. My wife will tell you I don't do that, and I hadn't done it in years. But I have seen some trends among certain people that's starting to dress in certain ways that I don't want it to catch hold among the young people. Now listen to me. Listen to me. You might say, well, Brother Kilpatrick, I don't appreciate it. Well, you ought to appreciate a man that's trying to help protect the presence of God. You ought to appreciate that. Now listen, let me move on here for a minute. Do I think that seductive clothing is going to cause the Spirit of God to lift? Not in a few it won't, but if we become too familiar with the presence of God and people start letting the world creep in, it will. Now, the second question is this, Brother Kilpatrick, are you trying to legislate holiness? Absolutely not. I wouldn't if I could. What you do in the confines of your home and all that, that's completely your business, and I wouldn't rule your life if I could. But when we gather here, and you're on the prayer team, and you got on a blouse so tight that it's causing a 14-year-old boy over there to lust, that will grieve the Holy Spirit. That will grieve the Holy Spirit. Say what you want to. You can say what you want to. You can blame me. You can not like me. But there's one thing about it. I will not put people and their idiosyncrasies and their little moody ways above protecting the presence of God. I won't do it. And so, I believe that you can be completely modern, but yet be modest. I believe you can be modern, but be modest. I believe that. That's the way I believe it. And I may be a dying breed. I also know that. I may be a dying breed. And some of you might be saying, well, Brother Kilpatrick, other preachers don't preach like you do on television. Yeah, but other preachers hadn't experienced what I've experienced either. They hadn't experienced what I've experienced. When you have had the Lord come down in your church that you pastored with such great power and such great glory, and has drawn millions of people from all over the world, you come away with a different perspective than most other preachers. I'm not saying I'm better than other preachers. I'm not saying I'm more holy than other preachers. And I'm not saying they're worse than I am. That's not what I'm saying. All I'm saying is I'm responsible for John Kilpatrick. And I'm responsible for church in his presence. And if you want to come here, I want you to come here. But if you don't think that you like me and you don't like my stand, there's plenty of places that you can go and dry right up on the vine. There's plenty of places you can go. But I want to have this place, I don't care if it is a rented auditorium. I don't care what goes on here during the week. They may dance and carouse and all kind of stuff, but whenever we come in this place on Sunday, I want the glory and the presence of God to be in this place. I want you to walk in and feel the presence of a holy God in this house. Can you shout amen? It's true. So I expect my family to reverence the glory of God and the presence of God. I expect my staff to do it. And everybody that's associated with my staff to do it. I can't tell you what to do. And I wouldn't if I could. That's not right. That's not a preacher's job. All the preacher's job is to do is be a herald. Be a newspaper boy. And tell people what God says. But I'm not going to try to run your life for you. But I will say this. The glory of God is so important to John Kilpatrick that even if it costs me friends, and even if it makes me look bad in the eyes of other preachers, even my own denomination, I'll just have to look bad in their eyes. I'll just have to look bad in their eyes. Because as long as I live, as long as my heart beats, as long as I live and pull air in my nostrils, I want to be cognizant of the fact that I'm to help protect the presence of the glory of God. Brother Kilpatrick, are you saying we have to dress like old-time Pentecost? No, that's not what I'm saying at all. I don't want my wife dressing like that. I want my wife to be spicy. That's what I want. I want it to be spicy. I want it to be frisky. Glory to God. I want that woman looking good. But how many knows you can be frisky and feisty, but yet still be holy? Amen. And not be seductive. There's a difference.